Hey Sagittarius, welcome to my YouTube channel. Revolution. Welcome guys. Hello to the new subscribers and to the loyal subscribers. Welcome back guys. I'm so happy to have you here. So my readings are timeless guys. These are tarot readings. I channel a message for you by my meditation, which I say in the beginning, and then I start off with my reading. Okay, so guys, in my meditation, what I got for you guys was that you guys are feeling very scatterbrained. Okay, like you don't know what to focus on, like you're wondering. Okay, I'm getting that very kind of dreamy kind of vibe, but not just dreamy, it's also very scattered, like you don't know what to focus on really. Like your focus is very much scattered into a lot of different arenas, and that is even confusing you more, is what I'm sensing. Okay, this could be regarding a person also, this could be regarding a situation that you are in. Okay, and because you're scatterbrained, it's causing a restless energy towards someone, or this could be someone towards you. Okay, restless as in you might feel rushed towards something, or someone might feel like rushing towards you to tell you something. Okay, so take it how it relates guys, it goes vice versa. Okay, that's what I saw in my meditation. And the second download I got for you guys in my meditation was that I just got like wrestling. So maybe you guys want a career in wrestling, or you're playing a lot of wrestling games, or you are watching wrestling match while you, like, you know, you want to watch a wrestling match tonight, or something on those lines. When you're watching this reading, like something about wrestling relates to you, then this message is definitely going to relate to you. And this is a timeless reading guys, so this will relate to you like anytime you watch this. Okay, so this doesn't just have to be like a specific date that you're watching that it will relate to you. Okay my loves, so yes, beautiful. So this is for Sagittarius, Sun, Moon, Rising, Venus and North Node. Let's get into your reading. So I'm going to be pulling from the Queen of the Moon Oracle. Okay, let's see what energy is coming towards you currently. What is it that Sagittarius needs to know about? What is Sagittarius's energy right now? What is Sagittarius's energy right now? How is Sagittarius feeling currently? Sagittarius, Sun, Moon, Rising, Venus and North Node. I'm not going to take the other card. I see pleasure in reverse, Sagittarius. Okay. So yeah, this is about you closing yourself off to any form of pleasure that you can seek from the world. Okay, you're shutting yourself down from that. You have, this is also, I'm getting a sense of like quitting any form of bad habits that you had from your past also. Okay, like quitting any bad habits or any addictions that you had, especially any toxic addictions. Maybe you had to go to rehab for them in the past. Okay, but now it's like you're planning to do that, or it's like you are finally like done with the pleasures. Okay, this can also be like, you know, you're done with the pleasures of life, like you're done and you don't want to, like you're bored of them, like you're bored of the pleasures of life. Okay, and you don't want to like explore them anymore. Okay, this side also could be your person. Okay, so take it how it relates guys, but yeah, that's what I'm seeing. Let's see, what is Sagittarius feeling? How is Sagittarius feeling right now? What does Sagittarius need to know? What does Sagittarius need to know about their feelings right now? Okay. Yes, look at that. So faith, that is your card, Sagittarius. This is you. You rule the leaps of faith. That's what I say, right? That's what I always say. But yeah, this is you really wanting to nurture yourself here. You might be very fertile here, Sagittarius, so you need to protect yourself, especially when you are intimate with someone else. Okay, because you will definitely conceive. Okay, it's a great time to conceive. If you guys are planning to do that, then yeah, go ahead. 31st of any month that you're watching this might be significant for you. Okay, for this connection with your person. Okay, But yeah, I feel like you are having faith within yourself. You have a lot of self-determination to see yourself through, especially if you are pregnant right now, Sagittarius. It could be that you are quitting any bad habits so that it doesn't affect your child, is also what I'm getting here, right? And also, you could be caring a lot about nature right now, like you want to like go out there, go outdoors and celebrate life the way it has never been done before. Maybe you want to be with your soul tribe, soul family, right? I mean, nothing better than that, especially when we grow up and we are adulting for so long. We need that inner child to come out and play, right? Just like we have always been adulting for so long. We feel that, and I feel like you are coming out with that, and you have a lot of faith within yourself that you will see your business projects through, you will see this relationship through. You are closing your eyes and you're having faith within the situation that this will work out no matter what happens, okay? And that is beautiful. This is pure Sagittarian energy, and I love you guys for this. This is amazing. Like, literally, if you guys were in front of me, I would like literally kiss your forehead right now. Not even kidding. Like, so cute, adorable energy right here, Saggies. Love you guys. Beautiful. I know it got a little cheesy, but yeah, that's gorgeous energy right there. Okay, you're having faith that you can quit your addictions. You're having faith that anything that is no longer serving you needs to be out of your life. Okay, that's your faith, and that's God supporting you with your faith. Right there. Tell me about Sagittarius's person. How is Sagittarius's person feeling about Sagittarius? How's Sagittarius's person feeling about Sagittarius currently? How's Sagittarius's person feeling about Sagittarius? Release. Ooh. So 27th again will be very significant for your connection, but I'm seeing. There's a lot that your person wants to tell you, Sagittarius. I was telling you that impatience, that wanting to say something but not able to, that feeling of lump in the throat, right? Look at that person. I mean, they want to talk to you about a lot of things, Saggy, but they're not able to. They're not able to. They feel stuck. Okay? And it's because their root chakra is off balance, like they're not rooted. Okay, they might also be disconnected from their body. I'm getting a lot of heavy trauma in this person, Sagittarius. And you know what happens, Saggy, if you're, especially if you're a healer, and even if you're not a healer, if you're a Sagittarius, like you will meet a lot of people who have been through like heavy traumas, okay? Because you also, since your childhood, have to go through certain things, okay? So yeah, this person has had a disconnection from their body, is what I'm sensing, okay? They might also be wanting to talk about their out-of-body experience with you. I don't know why I'm getting that. Okay. Yeah. This could be someone from spirit also wanting to talk to you. Okay. So if you feel awkwardness around that, I mean, why are you feeling awkward about that? There's no point in doing that. Like, research a little bit about these things, right? If you are interested in them. Like, no need to feel awkward about that. It's okay. Universe got your back, man. No issues, like. Yeah. So, but yeah, this person has a lot to say to you and a lot to release in front of you. They might even cry, they might even weep in front of you. They wouldn't know how to express themselves about how they feel towards you. Okay? There's a lot of, wow. A lot of energy that they want to bring towards you, my loves. Maybe some secret that they want to let out here. Tell me about Sagittarius's person. How is Sagittarius's person feeling about Sagittarius? How is Sagittarius's person feeling about Sagittarius? They feel like without telling you, they will not be able to transform the situation. Yeah. They feel like it's extremely chaotic without telling you. Like they don't have any peace in their life when, they are not able to release and be who they are in front of you in some way. Okay? They feel trapped within the material form, within the material body, whatever you want to say, whatever you want to call it. Okay? But yeah, they feel that there's a lot of chaos when it comes to not being able to tell you the truth.
and they know that you see right through them, Sagittarius. You see right through them without them telling you what they want to tell you. Like, you know that they want to tell you this, you know, that's also what I'm picking up. You know they want to bring it out in front of you. And without that, they won't feel the peace within, okay? They might have hidden something from you, and when you ask them, they never told you that, and now they are kind of feeling trapped within their own mind about it. Like, you know, what should I do now? You know, now that I didn't tell Sagittarius about it, now they will think of me as a liar. Now they will think of me as a cheater, you know? So, yeah, a lot going on within this person's head. Like, look at that. As I said, head. Look at the head. Right? Like, so many thoughts going on within this person's head. And, of course, there's a secret that this person wants to hold on to and control. But, you know, it's not going to help. It's not going to help. Because, obviously, you're going to take your energy back, your pleasure back from this person. And you're going to focus on yourself. You're going to focus and have faith in God that, yeah, if this person is not for me, then there's someone else for me who will be honest to me, who will be forthcoming, upright to me, loyal, trustworthy, right? I mean, Sagittarians, you guys are very passionate. You guys are very determined. You're very focused, goal-driven. You love to make people happy, make people shine, right? You are also the eccentric of the zodiac. You don't like commitment. I know that, you know, especially like getting tied down somewhere, you feel trapped with that. You want to be free. You enjoy the freedom, right? And if there is any form of entrapment that any person brings in your life, then obviously they're going to get a shock of their life, right? Because that's not your energy at all, right? Now let's see, what is this pleasure in reverse about? Tell me about pleasure in reverse for Sagittarius. What is this pleasure in reverse? Tell me about pleasure in reverse. Tell me about pleasure in reverse for Sagittarius. Hello. Distant, distracted, deep in thought, detached, aloof, not feeling it. Find answers in music. So Sagittarius, it seems like, you know, you're completely disconnected from this person in the past is what I'm sensing, okay? And yeah, you wanted to distract yourself. You didn't want to listen to this person anymore because you felt like there was no point in, you know, getting the answers out from them, because they were very persistent in not wanting to say the truth or not wanting to get it out, okay? There's something that they're hiding and you know it internally, right? Your intuition is popping. And that's why you detached yourself, okay? And you might be listening to a lot of music, okay? Especially when you miss this person sometimes, okay? Like, most probably, yeah. Okay? But you're not feeling it anymore. Like, that's what I'm sensing. Like, you want to detach yourself and not have any form of codependency regarding this situation. Okay? That's beautiful, Sagittarius. Tell me about faith. Tell me about faith for Sagittarius. Yes! Oh my God! Being yourself, confident, loud and proud, hitting the right note, harmonious concert, showing off and rocking it. Sagittarius, oh my God. As I was calling you eccentric, right? You're rocking it. You're being yourself. As you leave this person, or like you stay away from this person, it seems like you're rocking it and you're being yourself, confident and loud and proud, okay? Like, it's like this person was kind of trying to put you down or trap you in a situation, or you felt trapped within the situation, but as you disconnected, you felt like, you know, yourself again. You might be wearing a lot of blacks, you might be listening to a lot of rock music, or your person might be into rock music, I don't know. But yeah, this is about you getting in your mojo, like, you know, getting your mojo back, basically. Tell me about Sagittarius's person. Tell me about the release for Sagittarius's person. What's this release for Sagittarius's person? Sagittarius, Sun, Moon, Rising, Venus and North. What is this release? Glam it up. Ooh, bring your A game. Hitting the town, make an effort, edgy venue. The finishing touches, stylish. Wow, oh my God.
Look at that.
So, if this is a new person, Sagittarius, it seems like you are meeting a match. Okay, because this person, as soon as they see you being all up in your game, this person wants to take it up a notch. Like they want to show you who's boss, right? Look at the vibe. And this person wants to dress up for you. They might wear a lot of black dresses. They might have a tattoo, okay? They might wear long earrings. They might have short hair, of course. They might be tall as well, okay? Good booty as well is what I'm getting from these cards. But yeah, this is a person who is like, yeah, I'm gonna bring my A game, Let's go. You want a party? I'll show you how party is done. You want to do this? I'll show you how it's done. This person is like, this person wants to take it up as a challenge, is what I'm sensing. Okay. That's also what I'm getting. But yeah, this person wants to, you make them want to release their fears. You make them want to step out of their comfort zone. They feel free. Why are my words getting like that? Maybe this person has some speech problems, or they get stuck while talking, or I don't know why I'm getting for so many signs right now. I'm channeling, right, as I do your videos. So yeah, but this person feels like you free them up, okay? Like they can be free in front of you, like they can be who they really are in front of you, and that makes them want to, like, the words come up to their mouth and then they stop themselves, or they like, this could be the trauma that I was talking about. Like they are not able to open up about their trauma to you, Sagittarius. Tell me about peace in reverse, and that is what causes them to have no peace, okay? And you also disconnect because of that. Like you disconnect the sexual intimacy within this situation, or you disconnect, you detach yourself, okay? You guys are mirroring each other's unhealed parts, okay, guys? You guys are mirroring that. So it's important to take a look at those parts of yourself. Why do you detach from a person when they are not open to you? What is it that makes you not trust this person completely, right? And dive deeper into that. Tell me about peace in reverse for Sagittarius's person. Blowing bubbles, okay. Fun loving, bubbly, manifesting, embracing the moment, airy, flowing, being in the now. So yeah, this person is, I mean, this person tries to be in the now, but they're not able to, right? This person definitely, when they are around you, Sagittarius, they feel like, they are in the moment. But when they are not with you, they feel like things are like falling apart. And yeah, okay, that's what I'm getting. Okay, so this person might have a lot of possessive traits. Okay, that's where the trust issues come from. They might be very possessive about you, Sagittarius. They might feel what you're doing, where you're going. And Sagittarius, we all know how much you hate that. Okay, I mean, we all, as in I know how much you hate that. Okay, so yeah, that's what I'm getting. Let's see the mutual energy between you guys. I want to know what the mutual energy is. Tell me about the mutual energy between Sagittarius and their person pertaining to this spread. Whoa. The void. So yeah, there is an emptiness within this connection, right? Because nobody wants to open up about their past. Nobody wants to. You both feel a void within, Sagittarius, and this is the truth. Like you feel empty inside when things are not going right, and you need to address that. This is where the shadow work comes in, guys, where it's important that we dive into our shadows, the parts of ourselves that we have repressed, that we have suppressed in our lives, okay, that we have not worked upon. Now is the time to do it. Like, start journaling about your past experiences and how those experiences have affected you, okay? Once you start journaling about them, if you don't want to write it down, you can make a video or make videos on these experiences, okay? And once you make videos on these experiences, you'll feel much lighter. Like you have brought your shadow in the front, right? And you have like written those things down or made a video on those things. And then you can be like much more open about it. That's how you will open your heart, Sagittarius. And integrate your shadow. Like learn to integrate your shadow within your day-to-day life. There's a lot of, check out Queen Cup shadow work on YouTube. Just type Queen Cup shadow work on YouTube. Okay, Queen Cup with no space. Queen Cup space shadow work. Yeah, shadow work.
Tell me about the void. So tell me the mutual energy. You both feel lonely without each other. Like, this could lead to codependency, guys, okay? This could lead to a lot of codependency, although you have a lot of faith within your life, okay, Sagittarius. But whenever this relationship is not going well, it's like you feel empty within. This person also feels the same, like, without you, they're nothing. Without them, you're nothing. This could also be one of... But that's... that. Not. I'm not getting that from your side. I'm getting that from their side. More. Okay? They are more codependent on you, is what I'm sensing. But yeah, the void energy is mutual. So you both feel like there's an emptiness that needs to be filled. Or, and that's how you fill it with distraction, Sagittarius. Okay? Because, of course, the secrecy card is out. I was telling you the secret that this person is holding on to, and now it's out. So yeah, this person almost tells it and then they can't. And I think they are mirroring you, because Saji, you also haven't opened up completely to them. And I'm not saying that completely open up, but you know, it's important to, for a deep relationship to happen, there needs to be something that you know, we reveal to each other about our past, okay? But this is also an affair. Oh wow, okay, hiding something. So this could be, you guys are hiding this connection from others, okay? If it is regarding protecting this relationship from others, then that's a different energy, guys. But what I'm picking up here is that you guys are secretly dating each other, and maybe you have other people, okay, that you have in your life. An affair, hiding something, use discretion, surprise, collaborate, protecting. So yeah, protection. I'm getting protection, definitely. I got protection for you guys. Like, you guys are trying to protect this connection so that no evil eyes put, of course, on this connection. But yeah, there is a lot of denying of emotions within this connection as well. Okay, although you guys make each other feel like, you know, you guys are on top of the world when you're together. You dress up for each other, you go have wine and dine with each other, or, you know, do certain things, or maybe, you know, do very flashy things with each other, is what I'm sensing. But that's not the core of what this relationship can have as a foundation. You know, the core has to be stronger than that, okay? And what I'm sensing here is that, you know, hiding this situation is not going to fill the void here, okay? It's about opening up to each other completely and being vulnerable, okay? And that's what you both are scared of somewhere. Even though you have faith, Saji, that they will open up. And of course, you don't trust others easily. I know that, Saji. The screw. Not interested. Leaving quickly in trouble. Yeah, so as soon as, like, you know, things don't work your way, like, it's, you guys leave the situation, or, you know, situation completely, like, dissolves, or, you know, it gets shafted, or, you know, you just tell them off and you just leave without, like, explaining what's going on, or they do the same thing, like, you know. This could be a pattern that's playing out because you guys are scared to really open up to each other, okay? All right, wow. So, now I'm going to be pulling for your career, Saji, and then we'll look at an advice for you guys, okay? I'll pull, like, two cards for your career, and then we'll dive into your advice for the love relationship. So, let's see. Give me career advice for Sagittarius, Sun, Moon, Rising, Venus and North Node. Luck, yes, of course. You guys are ruled by Jupiter, which is the planet of luck, abundance and fortune, right? Look at this matching my background, like with Buddha and the leaves. But yeah, your luck is about to change for the better. You could get a lucky break, some financial breakthrough. Anything you do now will be very prosperous for you. Wow, Sajis. All the best, my loves. And yeah, I mean, if something comes your way, do send my way as well. Oh, I'm just kidding, guys. But yeah, of course. Of course, my PayPal is down there. I love kidding with you guys. Okay. So yeah, let's see. What else is there, an advice for Sagittarius for their career? One more advice for Sagittarius pertaining to their career. Sagittarius, Sun, Moon, Rising, Venus and North Node. Okay. So I got this card in reverse, okay? This is the Destiny card. So yeah, this is about you feeling like, you know, sometimes... Saji, you know, you can be a little pessimistic. You can be a little bit pessimistic about your destiny, about your goals and life, okay?
This could also be an overabundance that causes you to be spoiled. That is one possibility of this energy. Like, you have a lot of luck, so you don't mind walking all over people, okay? But I'm definitely sensing that energy, so don't do that to other people, okay? Just because you're in a better position than them financially, mentally, emotionally, don't try to step over people, okay? That is not a good thing. But yeah, if you feel like you're pessimistic about your destiny and things like that, then no, luck is about to rule for you, my loves, okay? So be very optimistic that things are about to turn around in your finances, okay? You might not be believing in your dreams and passions, okay? Like, and then what's to follow when you don't even believe in your dreams and passions? And you don't believe in whatever led to you in this until this point in your life, you know, that it was for your higher purpose. And there is no excitement and adventures that await you when you don't feel like that anymore. But that's not true. That's like depression. That can be one mild form of depression, guys. So yeah, it's important to know that luck is on your side. So it's important that you are on that wheel of fortune. Okay, I'm getting that wheel of fortune vibes here with the Sagittarius card, of course. Yes, look at that at the bottom of the deck. Media. Step into the spotlight and get seen. Don't allow your talent to go unnoticed. A career in television, radio, magazine, or any mass media job might be perfect for you. This could also be YouTube. Like, if you guys want to start a YouTube channel or a podcast also is what I'm getting. Okay, start doing it. It'll be very profitable. It might be time to get more publicity if you want to increase your finances. So publicity is equally important for you guys. As much as you guys like to collect the knowledge that you have, it's important that you gain more publicity for what you know, okay? Because you guys are the teachers of the zodiacs. It's important to step into that role, all right? Not just teachers, but like, you know, I'm just saying, like, leaders, basically. All right, my loves. So I'm going to be pulling from... Yeah, I want to pull from the power of surrender, just to see, like, you know, how can you elevate the situation with your person here. Tell me about Sagittarius's love spread. Like, give me an advice for Sagittarius pertaining to their love spread. Give me an advice for Sagittarius pertaining to their love spread here. Give me an advice for Sagittarius pertaining to their love spread. What is it that they need to embody? Surrender unhealthy relationships, Sagittarius. So I was getting that codependency, right? Let go of relationships that don't serve you, including unavailable or toxic people. You deserve to be treasured by others and to be surrounded by positive people. So yes, Sagittarius, you might have dealt with a lot of relationships in the past which have caused you a lot of damage, hurt, okay? This could be a lot of people who always wanted to, like, force themselves upon you in some way. Like, you know, completely depend upon you, and you, like, you had to, like, escape in a way that, you know, it caused a lot of trauma because you had to escape these relationships. This could also be stemming from your childhood, okay? Where you had to deal with a lot of... and that caused you to, you know, stick with unavailable people, okay? Because you were with so many codependent people in the past, it caused you to, you know, start, like, you know, being with unavailable people, people who detach themselves. And I'm getting that vibe from this person also, like, they are completely shut off, they're not wanting to open up to you, okay? So you guys are mirroring that about each other. It's important to be treasured by others. You deserve that, right? And to be surrounded by positive people. So, Saggies, it could be that, you know, you might be surrounded by a lot of negativity, negative people, negative influence on your life, on your goals, on your careers, which is causing you to lose your faith on your destiny even, okay? Which is causing a mild depression in your life. So, yeah, it's important to address these things so that you can move further, right? And evolve. That's what the goal is in this life, guys, to evolve. Let's see, what is Sagittarius's advice for their love spread? What is Sagittarius's advice for their love spread? What is Sagittarius's advice for love spread? Surrender to setting limits. It is healthy to set boundaries in relationships. Practice expressing your needs. Yeah, I was telling you that forceful thing, right? Where people force themselves upon you. So you had to learn to say no. Like, stop, enough, I don't want to. Okay, and people never understood that, you know, you're saying no, like they wanted to always like try to define your boundaries. They didn't let you define yours, but they tried to define your boundaries. Okay, and if you said no, then they would do more of that, or they would rebel against that. Okay, I'm getting lots of different scenarios, guys, but that has caused a lot of trauma for you, Sagittarius. It's important to let it go. It's healthy to set boundaries in relationship. Practice expressing your needs, and remember that no is a complete sentence. So yeah, it's important that you tell your partners what you need in a relationship, Sagittarius. If you are holding back and you have a lot of secrecy, that you don't want to tell your partner how you want to be treated within this connection, then things are going to be imbalanced. Okay. All right, my loves. So now, I'll pull an advice. I think I want to pull from the wisdom of the oracle for you guys. Of course, wisdom is all about Saggies. So yes, this deck is going to be used for you. I'm shuffling here, guys. One second. Let me know if you guys like this new layout of reading. I'm not using tarot, I'm using oracle decks. I'm liking it. I'm enjoying this, but I will definitely, if you guys want more tarot instead of this, then you can let me know. I'll do that. Okay. Whatever you want, just let me know in the comments down below if you are enjoying this. Also, if you would like to donate to the channel, please do so. Or donate a deck, I would be extremely grateful. Okay, I would like to give back to you all as well, the way you give to me. So yeah. Not for you, Sagittarius. Okay. Mind games, manipulation, control, tactics, not wanting to be available so that the other person thinks that, you know, I'm hard to get. Sometimes completely detaching and avoiding the most important conversations that need to be had, okay? It's important that you guys have that now. And especially when it comes to this person, it's like this person is extremely superficial. And if this is your ex, then this is definitely not for you, Sagittarius. Okay? I'm sure there is someone better. Let's read from the book for you guys what this card says for you. Number 6 might be important for you. Maybe it's your birth date or their birth date, or you know, or the date could be important, coming upcoming date. This person might like playing chess, okay? They might be very sharp at chess, or you might love playing chess. So let's see. A clear knowing that something is being denied you. Rejection is God's protection. The Oracle's message. There are times when it appears that no matter how deeply you desire something, no matter how hard you work at something, the result you seek always seems to elude you. It's as if you don't really get to be in the game, and you feel you're just watching from the sidelines. The appearance of this card indicates that you are not going to attain what you want right now, that indeed your dreams for that exact thing will not be fulfilled. This is a time to radically accept that not everything is available to you when you want it. Take heart. I was getting that energy from you, right? Like when you have an overabundance of something, that, you know, sometimes you tend to get spoiled, Saji. And that's what this card is kind of trying to humble you down in a way, that it's saying that this is a time to radically accept that not everything is available to you when you want it. Take heart, for there are benevolent forces who desire the best for you and have a much clearer idea of what is for your highest good. Rejection is God's protection. Something much better that will make you truly happy is on its way. Trust this, I was telling you, something better is on its way for you, right? So, yes. Relationship message. Some relationships carry an innate seed of failure in them that is obvious from the beginning, but the red flags escape your observation or you refuse to acknowledge them. When a relationship is not meant to be, it is not possible to make it be, right? Yeah, it seems like you guys are forcing it, even though there's an emptiness, there's a void, and there is secrecy, right? I don't know if it's clear. Yeah. when a relationship is not meant to be, it is not possible to make it be. Rejection is a sign that you are being protected by the divine. If you are the one who must reject another, remember that you do so for both your sakes. For every pot there is a lid. This one may not be the best fit. So this is you rejecting someone else, Sagittarius, and you're doing it because the divine is protecting you. Okay, the divine is already saying that you are making the right decision for you and this other person. Okay, mm-hmm. Because already there's a lot of difficulty within understanding each other within this connection. Okay, and this is not the right match, and a lot of red flags have also gone unnoticed from the beginning. Okay, so yeah, prosperity message. You can strategize and project and systemize and invest all your time and energy, but sometimes your best laid plans seem to go awry in spite of it all. Keep in mind that no effort is wasted. Fail fast and learn from defeat. Then keep going. You will eventually succeed, although perhaps not at this game, not at this time. Know when to fold your cards. Okay. So you might be also, you might love playing poker, or your person might. Okay. That's also what I'm getting. Protection message. Don't chase after what flees from you. Don't obsess over what eludes you. Don't bang your head against the wall. There is nothing romantic about what is unavailable. There is nothing romantic about what is unavailable. No price given for torturing yourself, and nothing to be gained by refusing to see the red flags that have been waving since you began your pursuit. Now is the time to walk away. There are other goals, other loves, other games, other successes waiting for you. The way out of obsessing is radical acceptance and surrender. Spirit wants only the best for you. This is a sign that you have something much better waiting for you. So trust. Beautiful Sagittarius. So yes, with this faith, I'm sure that you will use this energy for the right things, especially when it comes to understanding that, you know, not playing any mind games will benefit you the most, not attaching to unhealthy relationships. You have already detached is what I'm sensing, okay? But you still have this lingering thing, this pattern within you, okay? That you need to change, that you need to chase after unavailable people or toxic people, okay? Just because you have been through some stuff. Heal that so that, you know, you don't have to meet them on that level anymore, and you meet them on a level where you can heal them, you know? Alright, my loves? So, not for you. I hope this message is quite clear. So thank you guys. Thank you so much for watching, and make sure you guys like, comment, subscribe, and liking and commenting would really help as this would circulate my video. Okay. So thank you so much. Love you guys. Mwah, peace.